good morning, folks. It's Captain Banana, and it is Monday, January 22nd. And I'm 90 miles from Pittston, and, well, that's right. It's friggin' snowing. There's the cat, waiting for the windshield wipers. Look at that crazy thing. Get the windshield wipers, kitty. Get the windshield wipers. Yeah, you can't catch them. It's my little baby. Yeah, she loves chasing us windshield wipers. Every day it's the same thing. You'd think she'd learn sooner or later. You're not going to catch those windshield wipers. But she's been chasing a red dot or a laser pointer for, she's 6 years old now. 6 years. Well. But yeah, I'm 90 miles from Pittston, so. Yeah. Not a fan of the snow. Just sick and tired of this damn snow. But what are you going to do? March is around the corner. Alright, folks, it's Captain Banana. It is, I don't know, whatever day it is. Monday, February 22nd. And I'm in Pittston, and of course the snow followed me. So they're talking about getting 6 inches of snow today. You know, fuck my life. Goddamn snow followed me from Minnesota to Texas to Oklahoma to Springfield and now to Pittston. I just can't get away from this white shit. I just, I mean, and it's snowing pretty good too. You know, it sucks. Well, good morning, folks. It's Captain Banana. It is Tuesday, February 23rd. I'm still at Pittston. But, got to meet a relatively new driver yesterday. His name's Adam. Did a bunch of questions about trucking and being a company driver and everything. And I was able to answer his questions and help him out. You know, teach him a couple of tricks of the trade. And so added another subscriber. But it's kind of shocking how much I've learned in the short amount of time I've been trucking. Learned how to manage the clock and everything. I was able to explain the 2 split to them, 7.3, 7.5.3, 2.5 split, all that stuff. How to do the different macros as a company driver, how to get fuel additives and all that stuff when you're fueling, how to do a macro 19, important things that the Kiersey taught me how to do, now I've taught somebody else how to do. So it's all part of whole part of being a prime driver is you help the other people out, impart your wisdom upon them. Good morning, folks. It's Captain Banana. I have spent the overnight at the Allentown rest area in Pennsylvania. And parking's kind of a premium up here in the Northeast. There's not a whole lot of places to park. Allentown rest area is rather large, but it snowed, and I just don't understand what the people that do all the snow plowing are thinking. I mean, there's not a whole lot of places to park up here, so why in the hell would you put mountains of snow in parking spaces? I mean, we need to park here, but no. Some dumb fuck with a front end loader put a pile of snow up here. And I mean, it's not a small pile of snow either. I mean, it is huge. It's, oh fuck, it's at least 13 foot. And that's not the only large pile of snow, large mountain of snow. There's you know, that one over there. And there's that one over there. I mean, it's just, it's frustrating. You know, us truck drivers, we need a goddamn parking space. And, well, here's another problem. You know, I mean, use some friggin' intelligence. I mean, granted, you don't have to be a rocket scientist to operate a front end loader, but damn. You know, don't take up our parking spaces. You know, so I mean, I had to park next to a Swift truck, no less. Not a fan of parking next to a Swift truck, because God only knows what they're going to do when they pull out. But, you know, and all you Swift drivers that get butthurt about it, learn to drive. But no, seriously, I mean, it's just fucking stupid. It's, you know, you got a big-ass case front-end loader. You know, go drive an extra 30 feet and go stick the snow where it's not going to be in everybody's way, where you're not taking up a parking spot that we need. You know, be smart. Oh, that's right. I forgot. You work for the Department of Transportation, PennDOT. Yeah, can't be smart. Well, good morning, folks. It is Thursday, February 25th. 3 more days and this fucking February is over with. Thank God. So anyway, I'm at my 90. I did a 7.5, 2.5 split. So right now I'm off duty, but I'll have to personal conveyance to a truck stop or some place to park to finish off my break. I had to do it that way because, well, I was late getting to my shipper. It was a drop and hook, and I just didn't have, well, I could have driven it out, but then I would have been screwed because I would have been here way too early. So I did a 7.5 hour in sleeper berth, then I'll have to do another 2.5 hours off duty or in sleeper berth to reset my clock. But, yeah, sometimes you got to do the 7.5, 2.5 split, or 7.3 split, or 8.2 split. You know, just to make it on time to your shipper, because you can't get there too early, and of course you don't want to be late. So, but yeah, it's just one of them things. Spent my overnight in a rest area in Pennsylvania and got out of there and, you know, headed on to my 90 to get my delivery done. All right, folks, it's Captain Banana. It's still Thursday, February 25th. I'm in this long line at the Blue Beacon. You got to get the truck washed. Well, not really get the truck washed, but the trailer's a filthy pig, so the trailer needs
washed. What the hell is that dummy doing going in there with the gas pumps,
Trailer needs to be washed inside and out. It's filthy. So I'm on a drop and hook that's in Michigan. I got to pick up in Michigan and then deliver it to Jonestown, New York. And when I was doing the route planning on the GPS, well, the GPS decides it's going to take me through Canada. Like, yeah, that's not going to work because A, I don't want to go through Canada. B, I don't have a passport. And C, well, I don't want to go through Canada. So anyway, so I had to go into the settings and block out, like, you know, avoid Canada. Go north into Canada. No way, eh? So anyway, so I'm sitting here in line at the Blue Beacon. And, you know, we're all sitting in line at the Blue Beacon. we start cracking jokes on, like, you know, Swift and all that. Well, I heard one that cracked me up for Werner. We employ retards. No experience required. Thought, yeah, that's a good one. Well, good morning, folks. It is Captain Banana, and it is Friday, February 26th. Well, where the hell am I? Ohio. Yeah, I'm at a rest area in Ohio. Yeah. I got my drop and hook yesterday, you know. my trailer was filthy dirty. And I went to a Blue Beacon that does a fantastic job of cleaning out the trailers. Cleaning the trailers, the outside of the trailers, the inside of the trailers, and the tractor. Got everything all nice and shiny. But my God, I waited in line for 2 hours! 2 hours! Oh my God! Yeah, 2 hours I waited in line to get my truck and trailer washed. And I was so glad I didn't have my old trainer with me, because Eric would have been having a shit fit sitting in that line. Well, actually, he would have looked at the line and said, ah, fuck this, we're not waiting here to get the truck and trailer washed. Eric's not a very patient person. I mean, we would sit outside the wash bay at the terminal and, like, you know, sit in line for like 2 minutes, like, nah, fuck this, I ain't got time for this bullshit, let's go. And we'd just drive off. And consequently, his truck never got washed very often. But he always said, dirty truck makes money, clean truck doesn't make any money. Well, my truck's clean. After 2 hours, I'm like, fuck it. Sat here for 2 hours, I'm going to get everything washed anyway. But really needed it. But mainly went there just because, you know, the inside of the trailer was filthy and had to be washed. The outside of the trailer was filthy and had to be washed. And after sitting there for 2 hours, I'm fucking get it all washed. But anyway, so I'm heading to Jonestown, New York. Yep, got 2 days to get there. Got, let's see how many miles. 637 miles to my 90. And it's due, it's open window. So from, you know, 12:01 a.m. to 11:59 p.m., that's my appointment time. Doesn't say it's a drop and hook, but, you know, hours like that, looks like it's going to be drop and hook. Which would be cool, because I can drop it and get the hell out of there and get another load and make some money. But, yeah. I got to fuel up at a TA. That's, let's see, that's 260 miles from where I'm at. And, it's not a Lowe's, but it's a TA, and, you know, I got, I'll have points when I get fuel so I can take a shower. Shower time! Yep. Alright, folks, it's still, Friday, February 26th. I'm at my fueling stop, which is a TA, and, I've been to this place before. In fact, I had to get something fixed. I think, yeah. I had them fix an air leak last time I was here. But anyway, I'm going to go take a shower. I'm going to get something to eat. Not in any particular order. But, you know, do what I got to do. Well, good morning, folks. It's Captain Banana. And it is Saturday, February 27th. One more day in February is out of here. Anyway, I'm still in upstate New York. I'm 66 miles from my 90. I stopped at a rest area, spent the night. Got up about, I don't know, about maybe 5 o'clock in the morning, got underway. I should be arriving at my 90 around 9:30. But, I stopped at another rest area. I'm going in, brush my teeth, get a large iced coffee. You know, the usual. Get my day rolling. Well, I've had my day rolling, but get my coffee on. Folks, it's Captain Banana,
Banana.
Yeah.
Banana.
Captain Banana. And I'm here at a yogurt place. And I see one of my favorite YouTube truckers, No Hippie. But I was going to bang on his truck and wake him up, but I think he's in sleeper berth. But there's his pretty Peterbilt. I've never met the guy. I just, you know, watch all his YouTube videos. I don't know. I feel like a dick banging on his truck and waking him up to say hi. But, you know, you're sleeper berth, you know. Not really supposed to disturb people when they're in their sleeper berth. And, so that's pretty cool seeing his truck. It would have been nice to meet him, but, yeah, well, there's always another time. Well, happy Sunday, folks. It's Sunday, February 28th, the last day of February. That's right, March 1st is tomorrow. So, anyway, I departed New York. Got the hell out of New York State. And I'm in where the hell am I? Ohio? Yeah, I think I'm in Ohio. Yeah, I'm in Ohio. Yeah. Yep. So, I just did a macro 27 to get a better fuel rating.
Dispatch 732487 has been updated. A new message has arrived.
Okay, so dispatch. Nope. Still going to the same lows.
Asking for route.
Oh well. So much for. I mean, I got a quarter tank of fuel. I can easily go the 100 miles to lows.
Building route.
Well, whatever.